This morning is a rather special, not to say unique, occasion, because on the line now to us is E.L. Wistie himself, and perhaps he will comment on this alleged connection between the Watt Party and the Rainbow Alliance. Mr. Wistie, good morning to you.
Good morning, Steve.
Presumably you were a little sad when Rainbow George deserted the Watt Party to set up his very own outfit.
No, he never deserted the Watt Party. George was appointed Minister for Confusion for a brief spell of time, and as part of the plan formed whatever is formed at the moment. The Watt Party is already in control, and I think if you look round, you will discover that Mr. Weiss, Minister for Confusion, has taken one of the bold steps associated with the party, the Watt Party, by seizing control of the media. LBC is now in the hands of the Rainbow Alliance, and Lord Sutch, far from sleeping off a heavy night, is at this very moment stationed at the BBC and broadcasting non-stop on BBC One, BBC Two, and all other stations.
Is this one of the philosophies of the Watt Party itself, actually, to take over the media, not just the broadcasting stations, but also the newspapers?
Yes, I think if you see today's newspapers, they all contain pictures of Mandy Smith miming to a record. This is to detract attention away from various seizures being made up and down the land, and in fact abroad, because the Watt Party is not just a parochial British party. It is in charge in Australia, where you notice we have stolen their constitution and won't allow them to have even a look at it.
Is there a need for a new breed of politician at the moment?
No need at all, no. This is one of the glories of the Watt Party, is that everything it does is done for no purpose whatsoever.
And where are you drawing your membership from? I mean, I'll put that to George in a moment for the Rainbow Alliance, but as far as the Watts are concerned, I mean, is it restricted purely to Hampstead intellectuals?
No. Anyone over the age of 3 months is entitled to sweep into power at any moment.
Could you see in future possibly an alliance between the Watts and the Rainbow Alliance itself, being Watts, the Rainbow Alliance?
That is a semantic attempt to unite the parties, which are already united in their desire to remain doing exactly what they are doing, which is the right thing at the moment.
I mean, and the fact that you're doing all of these things, of course, must mean that you, as an individual...
have to get up early, yes.
You have to get up early, this is true, possibly because you were optimistic about the future of the country.
It would be hard to be anything but optimistic, given, as I say, Lord Sutch's seizure of the BBC and ITV at the moment, and George being in firm control of LBC. Now, I don't agree with his holding a gun to your head and making you sound natural. Anyone listening would think that you are fully in charge of the programme as opposed to the Watt Party. And to maintain that illusion, I shall shortly get off the line and pretend that you're getting on with it under no duress whatsoever.
Well, this is awfully kind of you. Maybe I could just ask you one last question then, whether you're going to put yourself up as a candidate in this forthcoming general election.
No, I might have an article in my clothing might stand, but not me in person, no.
Well, back to the tea and crumpets now then. Mr. Wistie, thank you very much.
Thank you.